Happy being depressed about having no one to fuck day. Hope you're not too depressed, because that's generally what happens on this day for people like us. But, yeah, I don't know. That was the best intro I can think up. Besides me wanting to whore something out, which actually, I'm going to do that before the battle starts. But there's this thing going on for me for Escape the Fate and Attack Attack's tour coming up where you can win tickets and a meet and greet. I'm going to leave a link in the description. If you click that link as many times as possible or something like that, I have a chance to go and win the contest. So I would really appreciate it because I would like to get free tickets because free tickets are nice. So, yeah, anyways. Hey guys, it's Wild. We got a match here against SugarHighGaming, standard OU match. It looks like he's, for the most part, using like a counter OU UU team. I'm just using that one OU team that you guys should kind of know by now. But looking at his team, Draco Meteor from Latios wrecks everything. I'm looking at that from a huge advantage, but the only problem would be his Spiritomb. If he's able to trap my Latios in some way, then it's going to be a lot harder of a match, because otherwise, the rest of my guys, it's basically an even matchup from that point, because, again, a lot of his guys couldn't take Draco Meteor, and after that, I don't have anything to hit his guys with Draco Meteor or something, and I don't have that much strength on this team besides Tracheon, and then he has guys to wall that, so after that, it'll be an uphill struggle, but we'll figure it out. But since all of his guys are weak to Latios, I figure Latios is the best lead no matter what he leads with. I can take any hit he has to go for, and then I can just hit whatever I want with a Draco Meteor, so I might as well just do that. But he's going to lead off with the Moltres, which Draco Meteor, just take it out. He doesn't want anything else to take the hit at this point because he'd rather preserve everything else. Plus, then he gets a free out to Spiritomb, which I really should have played around better, but now he's going to send in Spiritomb. I figure, okay, well, minus two Draco Meteor won't do that much. Maybe he won a Pursuit. But it turns out he does have the Pursuit, which means my Latios goes down. And that really sucks, because Latios would have been really good to have this match, like I did kind of point out earlier. But I'm going to decide to go into Magnezone. I figure getting a free sub up would be kind of nice, so I might as well try and do that. He's going to go to his Lantern, predicting me just go straight for the Thunderbolt. But I got the sub up, and now I'm like, shit, I cannot do anything to this thing. I was thinking about staying in and just HP icing just to try and get a little bit of damage off, but I just go to Gastro because I can take all of that thing's hits barring a Toxic. But he actually predicted me to go for the HP Grass and didn't want to stay in. That or he just plain predicted me to switch out. I don't know, but either way, gotta switch out there. Going to Jirachi because I know I can take any hit he wants to go for. Plus, I can get Rocks going if I really feel so inclined as to do that, which I honestly do. I like getting my Rocks up with Jirachi, so I might as well just go for it right now. Get those up for free, even though it's not technically free because I'm getting hit with a ton of damage like the Seed Flare, the Leech Seed, the everything. But now I'm going to opt to switch out because of the fact that I am Leech Seeded. I'm at minus 2 Special Defense, so that's not really going to work out in my favor. So I'm going to go to Tracheon, predict him, just go for HP Fire. And he's going to go into Lantern. I'm like, God damn it, I want Earth. Why can't I have Earthquake when I really want it? Then again, it's usually not useful in most situations, which is why I never have it. But anyways, gonna go for Stone Edge, predicting him to predict my close combat, and go for Stone Edge to hit the Spiritomb. But he's gonna go into Hitmontop instead, and I'm like, God damn it, that's gonna do nothing. But then crit, which is kind of shitty, but it might not matter later on, as we'll see. Possibly, probably not, but it probably did matter. But anyways, gonna go into Gliscor, because I can take any hit and then get free Toxic Orb going, and then Poison Heal for the rest of the match, so I might as well do that. But he's gonna have Shaman in. I'm gonna go for Ice Fang, just because I figure that a Seed Flare can't take me out, so I might as well get a little bit of damage going on it. He goes for the Leech Seed, it'll do its stuff, and then exactly, but, I forget what, there's not much to talk about right now, but alright, gonna go out to Jirachi, because I'm like, okay, well, I don't want to take a Seed Flare. I can take any hit, but he breaks me to switch out and goes for the Leech Seed again. And I'm like, no! I don't like that at all! Fuck you! I want to kill you! And I will kill you eventually, hopefully, maybe, we'll see, I don't know. But for the most part, I'm just gonna stay in, go for Seed, or not Seed Flare, Body Slam, as he goes for Seed Flare, because I'm like, let's paralyze him, and then maybe we can get a Freeze Switch out to something to kill it with something, so we'll try that. But anyways, like I said, go for the Body Slam. Does paralyze it, obviously. Well, not obviously. It's only 60% chance. I mean, it's not like it's the greatest chance in the world. But, paralyze it. Don't want to stay in, though, because I'm taking way too much damage at this point. But I can go into Magnezone and try and do some stuff to this shaman if I really want to. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to predict him to go to his lantern, predicting me to go for any move for that matter. So I'm like, all right, Terrakion, you can most likely kill this lantern with a close combat. You are a fucking Terrakion. Let's fucking do it. Close combat, his ass to hell. Or heaven, just kill it is the point. But no! Fucking no! Wow, Terrakion, why do you do this to me? Fuck you, and fuck you, Lantern, for living. But the point is, I don't kill him with close combat, and I die, and it's like, no! I kinda wanted Terrakion, because it has speed and stuff, and it would have been nice. But now I don't get nice things. So, bringing Jirachi, he's gonna go for Body Slam, because it hits Lantern. But then he switches out, which is weird, because then he just dies from rocks anyways, but then again, it would have gotten free lefties either way. But he's going to go into Spear Tomb. I'm like, I don't know what he's going to go for, so I'm just going to Iron Head him. But it turns out he's going for the Sucker Punch, so I'm like, hey, thanks for the free wish, because now he's going to Sucker Punch just because he's like, I'm going to kill you, but I'm like, no, I'm going to wish, and I wished. But now I'm thinking he might want to try and go for another Sucker Punch, so I'm going to go for the wish again, but he's going to go to his Hitmontop. Just because he can take any hits, and also he gets to intimidate me, which helps. But, like I said, just went for Wish in case he wanted to go for another Sucker Punch. So, you know, being safe is being safe. But, now that he's got the Hitmontop in, I don't really want to bullshit around with it and not get another Wish up or anything. So I'm just going to go straight for Iron Head to try and just get a little bit more damage off. Why not? But he's going to go to Rhyperior, I guess, predicting me to switch out, predicting anything. I don't know. But Iron Head does a little bit, and by a little bit, I mean, it literally didn't do that much, but gonna go into Gliscor now, who can do some stuff to it, but he's gonna predict me to switch out and go into Shaman, because Shaman can do stuff to Gliscor that Gliscor can't do to Shaman, which is, you know, those things. But he's gonna go for Hidden Power, and I'm like, fuck, it's ice, no, but then I'm like, wait a second, that's a good thing. Why is it a good thing, you ask? Well, Gliscor is the most useful thing in the world right now, plus HP Ice means that he doesn't have HP Fire to hit Magnezone as hard, so what I can do is go into Magnezone eventually and then just kill that fucker off. But he's going to go for the Leech Seed there, which I protected on because I knew that he could do nothing that would really backfire on me as I protected. So, you know, now I'm going to go to Magnezone and he's just going to fire off another Hidden Power predicting me to do something else. So, yeah. So, stuff. It doesn't do anything. Now I can fire out my own Hidden Power, and especially since his Lantern is so low, that means that I will have the upper hand, because if he goes into that, that dies from rocks. I don't gotta worry about anything with Magnezone right now, because it can basically 2KO most of his Pokemon. So I'm in a good situation, if I do say so myself. So, he gets the Leech Seed off, which is unfortunate, but I can still win this fight, because I am a Magnezone after all. But he's gonna go into Rhyperior, thinking, hey, I can take HP Ices, maybe, sort of, possibly, we'll see. But as it turns out, it does a bit over half, and a bit over half for the most part. But I'm thinking, okay, looking at that recovery, I'm thinking an HP Ice should still be able to take it out. So I just take the risk. I'm like, come on, HP Ice, you can fucking do it! And it does it, and he dies, and that's awesome, because now we don't have to deal with a Rhyperior anymore. Fuck yeah. But anyways, he's going to go into Hitmontop now, thinking, hey, I can live a Thunderbolt, because I'm a Hitmontop, and then kill with close combat, but, no. Which is probably where the crit earlier mattered, but, fucking shit, bullshit, monkey fuck. Yeah, exactly. But anyways, he's going to go into Shaman now, and just protect the stall for recovery, and do Shaman stuff, so that's what's going to happen here. But I'll be able to just HP Ice him next turn and, you know, do massive damage to his life points or something like that. But he's going to go back into Spear Tomb because he's like, I can take a hit. But I decided to go out to Jirachi because I'm like, I don't want to deal with the fucking stall because fucking stall bullshit. But now I'm going to start Iron Heading this thing. If he decides to Sucker Punch after I flinch him, then that's fine. But he's actually going to trick me, his Choice Band, thinking, hey, I'm going to cripple you with a burger bar on my Spiritomb. I don't know. But now he's going to switch back out to his Lantern just to quick die and then get a free switch out to his probably Shaman. I don't know why he'd go back into Spiritomb, but the point is he's going back out to Shaman, But now that I have a choice banded Ironhead, I'll do even more than before, and I don't know why he's protecting. I mean, sure, extra lefties, but he's not really benefiting that much from anything in general. But now he's getting a leech seed, but fuck you, I have a choice banded Ironhead, so that will do a lot, except not as much as I would like, but it still does a decent chunk. So next turn, I'll fire off another Iron Head and hopefully try and take him out. He's going to go for Seed Flare, which does nothing at all. Gets a special defense drop, whatever, that's fine. Iron Head goes off, and I get a crit, which really just sped up the process, because I would have just won anyways, because I still had Magnezone left to take on the Spear Tomb, and Shaman still probably would have taken me out, Jirachi me out that easily, or Magnezone for that matter, so it would have been game probably either way. But anyways, good game, Sugar High Gaming. So yeah, that was a thing, but yeah, good game. That'll probably be one of the only instances you'll see Yu's doing as well, just because my Latios got his ass kicked. But if you didn't have that Spirit Team, would have been a lot less close, but you know, that's kind of what happened. So guys, I hope you enjoyed. Remember, if you wouldn't mind helping me out, click that link in the description for the Escape the Fate attack thingy so I can try and win free tickets and shit. I'd really appreciate it, because then that means I have to spend less money on concert tickets. So, yeah, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed, etc. Rate, comment, sub, and later, guys.